now we'll start with the fishbone diagram. As I said, the fishbone diagram identifies the problem, the factors that are associated with that problem, and the causes of those factors. Again, multiple perspectives are important here. So I'm going to play this out with an example, and you'll have to humor us. We tried to come up with a very accessible example, which we'll carry out through the workshop, along with the English learner example. So this basic example should help to illustrate how to use these tools. And then during the activities, we'll ask you to use the English learner example for the activities, as you did just before. So for our basic example, we draw on something many of us may face, which is trying to be healthy and fit. So we want you to imagine that a woman makes a visit to her doctor, who runs some tests and determines that she's not in good physical shape. Specifically, she has elevated levels of cholesterol and blood sugar, which are represented by this delicious-looking cheeseburger. So she and her doctor determine that she needs to get to the bottom of this issue and increase her health. So she creates a fishbone diagram to further unpack the problem. So her doctor determines with her that the problem, which goes to the far left of the diagram, and that you'll see it looks kind of like a fishbone, is high levels of cholesterol and blood sugar. But what factors are contributing to the problem? Well, she eats fatty foods, and she doesn't exercise. But what might be causing her to, for example, eat fatty foods? Perhaps she doesn't have time in the morning to prepare her lunch, so she runs out and grabs fast food for her lunch each day. And in addition to that, she doesn't particularly enjoy cooking, so she finds herself eating quick and easy foods, which may be highly processed or high in fat. So you see here we're unpacking the problem step by step and beginning to examine the factors that contribute to the problem, and then beneath that, the causes. So she's setting herself up in this way to generate possible strategies to change some of these behaviors that are creating the problem.